Today we're going to try to motorize another model, and in this case this is the 42209 Volvo 120L electric front wheel loader. And this version is the original. It was built by Ronnie according to the, of course, instructions. And as you can see, it has four functions that we're going to motorize. And for that we're going to use the following components. The power functions medium motor is going to be placed here in the center, and it's going to be driving all the four wheels. Then I'm going to be using three micro motors, one for steering and two for lifting and tilting the shovel. And of course everything will be powered by a BuWizz 2.0, which is going to be placed here in the back. As usual, already made a sketch model here in LEGO Digital Designer, and here is the basic idea. Of course I'm gonna need some additional parts and probably more, but let's see how it goes. So the 4229 front end loader has been successfully motorized, and I'm quickly gonna demonstrate the functions. First we have the driving. The driving is actuated by a power functions M motor, which drives a 12 tooth gear, a 20 tooth gear, and then 20 tooth gear drives this 28 tooth gear, driving the rear differential and the front differential, giving this model all-wheel drive with enough power to easily spin the wheels. Then of course we also have the steering. For steering I'm using a micro motor that has been put in the spot of the original steering knob, and as you can see it can easily articulate the model, and when the steering mechanism reaches the maximum steering angle, this 24 tooth clutch gear protects the mechanism and the motor from overloading and jamming. Now, since this is a front end loader, we also have to talk about the movement of the bucket. So, the main lift for the bucket is actuated by this micro motor that's hidden inside the joint. It's driving the 12 to 20 tooth gears here, which are driving this 16 tooth gear, which is driving this 20 tooth gear, then twist 12 tooth gear, and then a couple of bevel gears transmit the power to the actuators, two actuators, one on each side, which do the main lifting. And then of course finally we also have the motorized functions of tilting the shovel. And to tilt the shovel I'm using a micro motor that's been placed here. It's driving a couple of 16 tooth gears, which are driving these bevel gears, which are actuating this actuator. The only compromise I had to do with this is I had to slightly limit the maximum upper position of the lift, only for like a centimeter or two, to prevent these bevel gears from touching each other, because I had to use smaller bevel gears here, since the motor is very close to them and the normal ones, the 20 tooth clutch, would not fit in here. That's the only compromise I had to do with in regards to the functionality. Regards to aesthetics, there have been no changes. I would dare say that I actually made the rear a bit nicer because I covered all the empty space and the knobs here. And of course I also managed to hide the BuWizz 2.0, which is powering the entire model down here, so I can easily access it by removing this beam. And now the BuWizz 2.0 can easily be turned on and charged and everything. So I'm really happy with the way this motorization turned out, and I can't wait to see how this model performs outside.